10,000 kg. Price paid, that is 9 lakh rupee. According to the seller price, 90 rupee per kg. And let's suppose the date of delivery is 2. After signing this contract, Islamic bank management can think about the risk involved in such a contract, because Islamic bank has paid to the farmer 90 rupee per kg. If the bank management thinks that after 6 months it is quite possible that the prices will be reduced till the level of 90 rupee or less than the 90 rupee, then Islamic bank would face a loss in that case. So how to mitigate its own risk? Then Islamic bank management can enter into another salam contract, but like this is Islamic bank and this is former, they signed the contract, paid full price, then he will deliver subject matter at 31/6/19, and this was 1/1/19. Now after that, Islamic bank management thinks that it is quite possible at this date Islamic bank may face loss because of the reduction in the prices, very low prices. So Islamic bank can enter into the another salam contract with, let's say, XYZ. This is a flour mill. Let's say this is the flour mill. Islamic bank will enter into another salam contract, and but in this first salam contract, we can say that this is the first salam. In this case, Islamic bank is the buyer, Rabbu Salam, and this is Muslim in a seller. In this case, Islamic bank when signed the contract with the XYZ, then Islamic bank will be considered seller and this XYZ will be considered buyer. Now the XYZ will pay the price to Islamic bank, and let's say what is the date, at what date Islamic bank can enter into the contract. It depends upon the, because as you know that selling price is less than market price. So that is why Islamic bank fixed 90 rupees per kg in the first salam. But when Islamic bank will enter into the next salam contract with XYZ flour mill, then XYZ flour mill will also look at the market price. If the market price is still at 100 rupees per kg, then there will be no change, or the roundabout XYZ will agree to pay at 92 rupee per kg, then it is a not big margin for Islamic bank to earn profit. So Islamic bank will wait until that its prices are high into the market. For example, if the prices of wheat are increased till the level of 120 rupee per kg, now this is the good, best, friendly environment for Islamic bank to enter into the another salam contract with another third party. Now Islamic bank will sign salam contract with XYZ, because now it is quite possible that XYZ will agree to pay Islamic bank at 100 rupee per kg. Now Islamic bank is buying at 90 rupee per kg and selling at 100 rupee per kg. The profit margin for Islamic bank is 100 minus 90, 10 rupee per kg. So this is the profit margin of Islamic bank, and Islamic bank can earn. Now, for example, this was the date 1st 4 2019. After 3 months, Islamic bank enter into the parallel salam contract. This second salam contract is called parallel salam contract. Isi ko hum kehte hain mutawazi salam. Islamic bank waited for 3 months just to wait for the friendly environment, and that was the market price. Now Islamic bank entered into the 100 rupees per kg salam contract to Islamic bank ne sign kar liya hai. Market mein 3 mahine tak intezar kiya, 2 mahine tak, taaki keemtein itni badh aaye कि जब वो सलम कॉन्ट्रैक्ट किसी और के साथ करना चाहे तो उसको एक अच्छी कीमत मिल सके ताकि वो मुनाफा कमा सके, तो इस वजह से वो वेट करते हैं. अच्छा, फिर डेट ऑफ डिलीवरी क्या रखी जाएगी, व्हाट वुड बी द डेट ऑफ डिलीवरी एंड टू दिस सलम सेकंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. इट इज आल्सो पॉसिबल दैट इस्लामिक बैंक विल गिव सेम डिलीवरी डेट दैट वाज द गिवन बाय द मिस्टर सेलर, बट दिस विल बी रिस्की फॉर इस्लामिक बैंक. It is quite possible that Mr. A is do not deliver the subject matter at this date, and if Islamic bank mentioned the same date to the XYZ and Mr. A could not deliver the subject matter at this date, then how Islamic bank will deliver subject matter on the same date? Then Sharia says that Islamic bank will be forced to buy the commodity from the market and to deliver the subject matter to XYZ. If market's prices are after 6 months at this date, if the market prices are high, then Islamic bank will face loss, because Islamic bank received 100 rupees per kg. If prices are high after 6 months at that date, 110 rupees per kg, then Islamic bank will buy commodity on high prices and to deliver, and it will deliver to the XYZ. Mehengi khareed ke phir isko dena padega. Is wajah se kehte hain ki bhi jo management hai, that will give, that will put is some days margin. Wo kuch na kuch margin rakhegi, aur wo ye kar sakti hai, wo keh sakti hai ki ji hum 4/7/2019 ko isko deliver karenge. Isliye ki if this guy seller is late 2 to 3 days, then still Islamic bank have margin, because it will deliver subject matter on 4/7/2019 to XYZ. So this is the way. This second contract is called parallel salam contract. This is called parallel salam, or jise hum kehte hain mutawazi salam. इसे हम कहते हैं मुतवाजी सलम. नाउ द फॉर द देयर आर थ्री नेसेसिटी कंडीशंस फॉर द वैलिडिटी ऑफ दिस पैरेलल सलम. नंबर वन, दैट देयर शुड बी नो ओनरशिप रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन दिस दीज टू पार्टीज, सेलर ऑफ द फर्स्ट पार्टी एंड बायर ऑफ द सेलर ऑफ द फर्स्ट सलम एंड द बायर ऑफ द सेकंड सलम. देयर शुड बी नो ओनरशिप रिलेशनशिप. व्हाट डज मीन बाय ओनरशिप रिलेशनशिप? Mean that if Mr. A has some shares in XYZ, then it means Mr. A is partially owner of the XYZ floor mill. Then this will lead, situation will lead toward the buyback. Baina, that is prohibited in Sharia. How it would be buyback? Because he is selling the subject matter to the Islamic bank, and he himself is buying the subject matter from the Islamic bank, because he is partially owner of the subject matter. If he is totally owner of the subject, this XYZ, then this will be completely buyback. So that is why Sharia and scholars put conditions that for the validity of parallel salam, this is necessary condition that this XYZ must be sole third party independent of the seller of the first salam contract. So number one condition ye hai ke bhai ke सेलर
मोबाइल मेरा
बायर ऑफ पैरेलल सलम मस्ट बी थर्ड पार्टी, वो थर्ड पार्टी ही होना चाहिए, इसका और उनके साथ आपस में कोई रिलेशनशिप नहीं होना चाहिए. देन पैरेलल सलम must be independent of first Salam contract. There should be no dependency between parallel Salam and the Salam contract. For example, Islamic bank manager cannot say to XYZ, when I will receive subject matter from Mr. A, then I will deliver to you. So this is the dependency. It means if he will not deliver, I will not deliver. So this will be dependency. And Sharia says that the contract must be free from any dependency. So contract jo hai wo kisi is tarah ki situations par do contract aapas mein contingency nahi honi chahiye. Contract free hone chahiye. So ye Sharia ki necessary condition hai. तो सलम के अंदर जहां पर ये कंडीशन है वहां पर ये कंडीशन भी सलम के अंदर लगाई जाती है. सो ये दो कंडीशंस हैं. सेकंड ऑप्शन इज मुराबाह. As we know that first option for Islamic bank after signing a Salam contract with A, how to sell this commodity, what was the option after signing this contract was second Salam contract, that Islamic bank will sell subject matter on Salam contract to the XYZ. But this was signing the contract before the delivery of subject matter. Now, Islamic bank has option to sell commodity on Murabaha basis. But unlike to Salam contract, Islamic bank can sell subject matter on Murabaha basis only after getting the subject matter in its own possession. It means, as Islamic bank executed second Salam contract on 1st April of 2019, Islamic bank cannot enter into Murabaha contract at this date. Why? Because it was allowed for Islamic bank to sell the subject matter that was non-existent on Salam contract, because the Salam can be executed on non-existent subject matter, but Murabaha cannot be executed on non-existent subject matter. It is necessary condition for validity of Murabaha that subject matter must be owned by seller, must be possessed by seller, and that must be existent. So that is why Islamic bank can sell its commodity only Murabaha only in a case only after getting the delivery of subject matter. It means that Islamic bank can sell Murabaha after getting the delivery of subject matter on this date only, not before than that. Is tarikh se pehle Islamic bank enter nahi ho sakta. Haan, at this date, after that date, Islamic bank can sell that wheat, 10,000 kg wheat on Murabaha basis into the market to any person. So this is the second option for Islamic bank. The third option is agency. Islamic bank can hire an agent who is expert to sell its product into the market on a good price. Then Islamic bank will pay some price as an agency fee. This will be called the wakala. Or also Islamic bank's management have expertise to sell commodity directed to the market. Then fourth option is that the bank management will sell commodity directed to the market and they will make profit. So these are the different options for the Salam buyer to further sell its commodity into the market. So these are the four options.